What if I told you there was one Node.js API that's really core to the Next.js App Router and many of the APIs that you use? That API is called Async Local Storage, and I want to show you an example of how it works and how the Next.js cookies and headers functions actually work under the hood. So I've got this example that I built using Bun. It's a simple Bun server that shows this model, and it shows how we can work backwards from a function like cookies that you can read inside of a React component to access the cookies on the incoming request. This is what it looks like in a Next.js application, but we can actually strip this back to the most basic example using a simple Bun server. So what I've done is I've created this Bun server, and I want to walk you through it right now. So there's a couple bits here. We're going to start at the bottom, actually, and work our way up to the top. The first is that we create a new Bun server. We're going to be running this on port 1234 locally. Given the incoming request with Bun server, so it's just using the web request API, we're able to produce a web response. So first, I take in that web request and I parse the cookies. This is just a helper function to actually fetch those headers from the request, get the cookies, and then reformat it a little bit more nicely. So I have these request cookies, and then I can use this dot run function. What is this dot run? Well, I have this cookies storage. If I go up here, this is where we're using async local storage. You can think about async local storage kind of like React context. So I'm able to share this store across different async operations in this request, kind of like how I can share data across different components in my React application. So I have this cookie store, and I say here, in this cookie store, you know what? Let's make those request cookies available. Now, inside of this, I use the React API to render this user component to a stream, and then I produce a new response using that stream. This rendered readable stream comes from React DOM directly, so nothing special here. This is just using some of the underlying hooks that frameworks usually implement for you, and then we produce that response. So what that looks like is we're given this user component. This user component can read from the cookies function, and it has access to that incoming request cookies. So I built this with Bun. I can run this locally with Bun run dev. That's going to start up this on localhost 1234. And we see on the right here, this component cookies. This reads name from cookies, and it has a name of Lee. So if I go to cookies 1234 here, we see name Lee. And I could also change this if I wanted to, reload the page, and it's going to read that new cookie from the incoming request. So yeah, that's really all it takes to build your own version of the cookies or the headers function that Next.js uses. Hopefully this helps you understand a little bit more about how Next.js works under the hood and some of the primitives that we build on. This isn't something that you necessarily have to use in your own code. This is just teaching you more about how the framework is built. But hopefully it was interesting. If you'd like to see us make more videos like this, please let me know. Peace.